The public became obsessed with the relationship between American actress Meghan Markle and British royalty Prince Harry from the moment that they went public with it. The world watched with rapt attention as the couple got married and had their first child, Archie. With all of the support also came lots and lots of criticism, usually projected at Meghan from the press as well as regular people on social media. She not only got racist remarks, but she was criticized for the strangest things, such as the color or cut of her clothes, or touching her baby bump too much in public, things other royal family members never had to put up with. British tabloids, such as The Sun, were major proponents of this critical culture towards the royal family's newest member. Still, it was a shock to the world in January of 2020 when Prince Harry and his wife Meghan Markle announced that they would be stepping back from their positions as senior royalty in the British monarchy. This absolutely unprecedented move was dubbed Megxit Online, and it raised many questions from why the couple were leaving their positions as the Duke and Duchess of Sussex, whether they would choose to reside in England or America, and how they would handle becoming financially independent from the royal family. Well, the public has finally received their answers in the form of a 3-hour interview with Meghan Markle and Prince Harry, conducted by Oprah Winfrey. If you haven't yet seen the interview, prepare yourself because the formerly royal couple dropped bombshell after bombshell about their struggles with the royal family and the circumstances that eventually pushed them to leave.
I just didn't want to be alive anymore. And that was a very clear and real and frightening constant thought.
Want to get the latest scoop on Meghan and Harry without having to watch the entire lengthy interview? Keep watching to find out the 10 most shocking secrets that Meghan and Harry revealed in their interview with Oprah. Interact with us. Subscribe and hit the notification button to be notified when we upload more content. Don't forget to leave a like and comment below. Also, feel free to suggest any type of videos you would like to see on this channel. Thanks! Number 1. Meghan's mental health crisis. In an emotional moment of the interview, Meghan revealed that during her time as a working royal, her mental health began to deteriorate to the point of having suicidal thoughts. She said, "I just didn't want to be alive anymore, and that was a very clear and real and frightening constant thought." She went on to say that all Harry could do was hold her and support her through her struggle. While Meghan was also given sympathy from the royal family, she was denied any medical help for her mental health from the royal palace because she was not a paid employee of the institution. Number 2. Racism in the royal family. The couple also revealed that while the Duchess was pregnant with their son Archie, Prince Harry was asked inappropriate questions about how their child would look. Allegedly, members of the royal family were concerned about the color of their son's skin and whether he would be too dark. Neither Meghan nor Prince Harry wanted to reveal what exactly went down in those conversations or who was involved, for fear of causing unnecessary damage to that person's image or revealing too much personal family business. Number 3. Meghan was silenced. Meghan told Oprah that from the moment that the public became aware of her and Harry's relationship, everyone close to her was told to tell the media no comment if asked any questions about their relationship. At first, Meghan believed that this was because the royal institution was trying to protect her privacy. Once she and Harry got married and her relationship with the royal institution began to take a turn for the worse, Meghan realized that she was not being protected, but rather silenced. The royal institution did not want her to tell the press her thoughts and her truth about her experiences with the royal family. She also made a distinction between the royal institution and royal family by saying, "There's the family, and then there's the people that are running the institution. Those two are separate things, and it's important to be able to compartmentalize that because the Queen, for example, has always been wonderful to me." Number 4. Prince Charles stopped taking Harry's calls. Along the line of the royal family stopping communication, Harry revealed to Oprah that his father, Prince Charles, had stopped taking his phone calls. When Harry was planning to step away from his duties as royalty, he did not abruptly announce this and blindside the royal family as many people believe he did. Rather, Harry had 3 conversations with his grandmother, the Queen, and 2 conversations with his father before his father stopped answering his calls. Instead, Prince Charles requested that Harry simply put all of his thoughts in writing. Harry said that after that, he just had to take matters into his own hands, despite what his father thought. Harry and Prince Charles are now on speaking terms again, but Harry says that this break in communication caused a lot of pain and that there are still a lot of issues for him and his father to work through. Number 5. Prince Harry has been cut off financially. In the Oprah interview, Harry also revealed that he was no longer receiving money from the royal institution. He stopped receiving palace money in the first quarter of 2020. Harry and Meghan have struck up some lucrative deals with companies such as Netflix. Harry says that the main motivation behind this was needing to pay for security costs for himself and his family. He went on to say that the only other money he has left is what was left to him by his mother, Princess Diana. Meghan said that the two of them were not being paid for the Oprah interview. Number 6. They're having a girl. Meghan and Harry happily revealed that their second child would be a girl. Meghan is due to give birth over the upcoming summer, and it seems like the couple couldn't be more excited. Harry said in an interview that he felt amazing, just grateful to have a boy and then a girl. What more can he ask for? We have our family. However, the couple did say that two children is enough for them, and they do not plan to have any more children after their daughter is born. Number 7. Meghan was rarely allowed to leave the house. Meghan also said in the interview with Oprah that when she was still a part of the royal institution, she was rarely able to leave the house. This is because any public appearance she made could potentially fuel gossip about her in the tabloids. She claimed the firm, another name for the royal household, was very worried about what people might say about her and wanted to uphold their image. Meghan said that she understood the royal family's concern, but that no one took into consideration how that affected her mental well-being and how sad and lonely she became because of her little social interaction. This, of course, was well before the coronavirus broke out and Britain's lockdowns took place. Number 8. Harry felt trapped in the royal institution. During the interview, Oprah asked Harry if he would have left his royal duties if it were not for Meghan. Harry said that he would not have left if it weren't for Meghan. He said that he felt trapped by his former duties, but for a long time he did not even realize it. When Oprah asked how exactly he was trapped, Harry said that he was trapped within the system, like the rest of my family are. My father, my brother, they are trapped. Number 9. They have no hard feelings against the Queen. Despite all of the things that the couple needed to get off their chest, things in the royal family were not bad all of the time. Meghan said that the Queen was always wonderful to her. She even recalled one time when the Queen gave her some pearl earrings and a necklace, and she got to share a blanket with her. Prince Harry also noted that he still had a really good relationship with his grandmother. He said that she is still his commander-in-chief. We'll have to see how things go with the Queen and the rest of the royal family after this interview has been released. Number 10. An exclusive look at their home. Harry and Meghan's interview with Oprah took place at their own home in Santa Barbara, California. While the interview did not particularly show off the home, viewers got a brief look into the couple's backyard. During the interview, Meghan and Harry's chicken coop could be seen. It was revealed that the rescue chickens that live in the coop provide fresh eggs for the family to eat. During a portion of the interview, Oprah held a carton of eggs and Meghan held a small basket of eggs. The cute little chicken coop says Archie's Chicken on it. It seems like the couple has a happy little home for themselves to raise their children and live a peaceful life in California, away from the restrictive royal palace. Hopefully, this interview helps to bring closure and peace to Meghan and Harry's tumultuous relationship with the royal family. So far, the Queen has released a statement on the interview, and while she did not directly address any of the claims made by Harry and Meghan, she did express sympathy towards the couple, said that conversations will need to be had privately within the royal family, and said that Harry and Meghan are loved family members. However, many people are not pleased with the Queen's short statement, which was only 3 sentences long, and want the institutional racism to be addressed quickly, directly, and effectively. Prince Charles, the father of Prince Harry, has been avoiding the press and has not made any comments on the interview. It is unclear what his reaction to the couple's claims are. Generally, the world has reacted to the interview with shock. The British monarchy has generally been regarded as an archaic but fairly benign system, but this interview blew the lid off on the racism, disregard for mental health care, and more that is clearly rampant in the royal institution. Many people have taken to social media to show support for Meghan and Harry and to condemn the British monarchy as a system. So, what are your thoughts on Meghan and Harry's interview with Oprah? Do you think that this is a necessary discussion that needs to be had about the enduring racism of colonial systems? Or do you think that Harry and Meghan have taken things a step too far in going public about these issues? Which of these mind-blowing secrets about the royal family shocked you the most? Join the conversation and share your thoughts with us in the comment section below.